Track 15. Unit 2. Listening 2. Part 4. Multiple choice.
Octopushing, elephant polo, ice racing or cheese rolling? Our sports correspondent, Mike Taylor, has been finding out about some of the world's strangest sports. Which is the most unusual one for you, Mike?
Well, I think it has to be chess boxing, because it's such a bizarre combination. A match starts off with a 4-minute round of speed chess, followed by a 3-minute round of boxing. There can be up to 6 rounds of chess and 5 of boxing before a winner is decided. Now, you may think this is just a bit of fun, but when I watched 2 men competing in a match on German television last year, I was amazed by their level of skill in each of these 2 very different disciplines. After all, boxing is such an aggressive, violent sport. It's about using the body, whereas chess is all about using the brain. You don't expect a boxer to be good at chess or a chess player to be good in the ring.
Have you found any other unusual combinations like that?
No, but at the beginning you mentioned octopushing, which is underwater hockey, so it's an unusual setting for a familiar game. I haven't seen it played, but I've read that it's a very exciting spectator sport. Major tournaments have TV screens which show the images captured by underwater cameras. I've also read that you don't have to be very fit to play, but I'm not convinced, to be honest. It seems physically very demanding to me. The good thing, though, is that because it's a team sport, no individual player has to stay underwater for long periods at a time. People like me, who can't hold their breath for very long, can keep coming up for air.
Not one for me, though, I'm afraid. What else have you got?
Well, there's wife carrying. That's where competitors race over a 250-meter course with a woman on their back. The female participant has to weigh more than 49 kilos, but she doesn't actually have to be the man's wife. So it would be more accurate to call it woman carrying, I suppose. Anyway, if she isn't heavy enough, she has to wear a rucksack with some kind of weight in it. The regulations are surprisingly strict.
Now that sounds all right. Fancy carrying me, Mike?
No. Bad back, I'm afraid. Actually, there are quite a few sports like this one that rather irritate me.
Why's that?
Well, they're a bit ridiculous, to be honest. Wife carrying, retro running, pea shooting, egg throwing. They all seem very childish to me. I'm sorry if that upsets listeners, but they're just not sports I'd want to do or even watch.
So which one is the silliest?
Well, it has to be toe wrestling, where you have to force your opponent's foot to the ground. It's fine for kids, and a toe wrestling competition is the kind of thing you might expect them to organise in the school playground. But for grown men and women to hold a world championship every year, and then for organisers to apply for toe wrestling to become an Olympic sport, well, it's too daft for words. I'm just pleased the application wasn't accepted.
All right, but you seem to like chess boxing and octopushing. Are there any more that impress you?
Well, how about the man versus horse marathon, which takes place every July in Wales? Human runners race cross-country against riders on horseback for 22 miles. That's around 35 kilometres. And on 2 occasions in the last 30 years, a human contestant has won. Now, that's not as astonishing as it might seem. Horses are fast in short races, but not so good over long distances. But it does seem a little unfair that the human victories are not mentioned in the same breath as some of the world's more famous sporting achievements. These people are heroes, but they're virtually unknown outside Wales.
Yes, it's the first time I've heard of the race. You're a runner, aren't you, Mike?
I was, but I damaged my knee when I was skiing and had to stop. I was a real enthusiast, used to run for a couple of hours after work every evening. But even then, I wouldn't have beaten a horse, that's for sure.
There's no shame in that. Right, thanks, Mike.